Welcome to the Rusted Garden Homestead. This video is all about growing your summer squash and your zucchini. And I want to go over a couple of things that I've done in other videos, but there are a lot of new gardeners this year. So I am, you know, going to go over the basics with squash and zucchini. When your plant gets to about this size, I actually bought this variety at a store because I had frost that came in and killed off a lot of my plants. It's just called a green zucchini. I'm not sure exactly what that variety is, but they all operate basically the same way. You'll see a zucchini form. This is a female plant, or a female flower. It's a baby zucchini with a flower on the end. This one is about to flower and open. When it opens, a male flower has to open somewhere or from another plant, and a bee needs to pollinate it. It needs to pollinate male to female, or this zucchini is going to brown tip and die off. If it's not pollinated, you're going to see zucchinis that get about 4 inches long, the tips get brown, they die off. That's because they weren't pollinated. That's not something you're doing wrong. So when you're looking at your zucchini or your squash plant, you're looking for female flowers. There's another one. You can see right here, that is a baby zucchini. So that's a female flower. And then this one's kind of odd. This is just a stem. So your male flowers are just a stem. There is no baby zucchini under it. And then it flowers. For some reason, this is a double flower. Don't know if it's the variety or something weird happened. However, there's another one here. So it's just a stem, and then it's usually a single flower. That's the male plant. This is a male flower right in there. It looks like just one flower. Just a stem and a flower. If I look, I think this one is a female. That's a little zucchini. So for it to work, you need pollination. So you want your plant to be producing female flowers and male flowers, and you want them all opening at the same time. Sometimes that doesn't happen. You may just see a bunch of male flowers, or you may just see a bunch of female flowers. You can't really do anything to change that. You just gotta wait on nature. Now, when you're planting these, you wanna have at least 3 feet of space. I put things a little bit more closely together, but if you're just starting, about 3 feet of space. I put one plant here. In the past, I put another plant in the corner and so forth, all the way around. So I'd have 4 plants in a 4 foot by 4 foot space, but I keep them to the side. Your zucchini plants, your squash plants will most likely get squash bugs. Squash bug eggs can be found on the underside. They're little tiny orange dots. When you pack a lot of plants together, sometimes it's hard to tend. So if you're just starting, put one plant here. In my other garden, areas, I've put in other zucchini plants, and this year I'm spacing them apart so that it's a little bit easier to manage pests and disease. Your zucchini plants will also get a white powdery substance on there that's called powdery mildew. That is not powdery mildew, but it could look a little bit like that. That is a dust that was on there. That's going to happen. I'll be talking about antifungal sprays you can put on your plants in future videos. You're also going to see leaf patterns like this. Let me just turn it a bit. Where it may look splotchy to you, that's not a disease or a problem either. Here's a good example. You can see that splotching in the leaves, that's just normal for this plant. That is not a disease. The powdery mildew, you will know. It just creeps across and it looks like a light dusting of baby powder on there. So everything that you see on the leaves isn't always a problem. Some zucchini, some squash will be totally green. Some will have some sort of pattern on there. Don't panic. If your female plant or your zucchini browns out and gets a brown tip, that's because it was not pollinated and you can't do anything about that. You just want a plant that's growing, looks green, it's producing flowers, producing male flowers, female flowers, and you should get plenty of zucchini. Hope that makes sense, gives you some ideas of what to look for in your squash and zucchini plants, and we'll do future videos on taking care of the problems that occur with these plants. Thanks for watching, and please check out my seed shop at therustedgarden.com.